Hello everyone. In our last videos on whole numbers, we saw different properties in whole numbers. For example, closure property, commutative property, and associative property. In this video, we will look at the distributive property. We will look at first distributivity in multiplication over addition. Now let's take a small piece of paper and draw some small squares on it. Now, how many squares do we have here? We have small squares, 1, 2, 3, I can count them, otherwise I can do a multiplication. So, I have 1 row, 2 rows, 3 rows, 4 rows, 5 rows, 6 rows of each having 5 squares, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6 rows each having 5 squares. So, I have 6 times. I have 6 times 5. Now let's assume that I cut this piece of paper at this. I cut it through this line. So I will have 6 rows, but in each row I have only 3 squares. So I have 6 times 3 squares. And here I have number of rows are not changed, but the number of columns in each row I have only 2 squares. So I have 6 times 2, 6 multiplied by 2. But do you agree that this is the same paper as this, because we have just cut the paper. So number of squares in both have to be equal. So this has to be equal. So I can write here as 6 into 5 or 6 times 5 is same as 6 times 3 plus 6 times 2. I add these squares with these squares, 6 times 3 plus 6 times 2 is going to be same as 6 times 5, because they are the same number of squares. But this 5, instead of counting it as 5, I count it as 3 plus 2. So what happens is, this changes into 6 into 3 plus 2 is equal to, and that is the rule. So, distributive property says that 6 multiplied by, in bracket, 3 plus 2 is same as 6 multiplied by 3 individually multiplication plus 6 multiplied by 2. So, I am distributing this 5 into 3 plus 2, and I am also use this 6 to multiply them individually. So, 6 multiplied by 3 plus 6 multiplied by 2, and that's what we have here, 6 multiplied by 3 plus 6 multiplied by 2. In general, this rule is written as A multiplied by, in bracket, B plus C is same as A into B plus A into C. So there is A, B, C are 3 whole numbers. So A, one whole number outside the bracket, which is multiplied. Inside the bracket, we have the other two numbers with plus, B plus C. Then it is equal to this A multiplied by this B plus this A multiplied by this C. A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. And that is our distributive rule. Let's look at this rule more closely now. So, how do we do multiplication? When we do multiplication, this A multiplies this B and we get a term. Then, so when A is gone to B, and now from B it is moving to C. But when it is moving to C, it encounters one plus sign in between. So, that plus sign comes here. So this plus sign is here. And then finally, when A multiplies this C, so when this multiplies this C, what we get here? A multiplied by C. So that is how we do the multiplication. This is also called as expanding brackets. We have learned expanding brackets in our earlier chapter, which is same as this. Now we need to understand that this formula is not to be looked from one side. So this formula, you should be able to see this formula as this. A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C is equal to A multiplied by in bracket B plus C. So when we have two multiplication terms, we have term 1 here and we have term 2 here. So we have two multiplication terms and in between them we have a plus sign. So two multiplication terms when they are added, and if we find in these two multiplication term there is one common factor. Now in this case A multiplied by B, what are the factors? A and B are the factors. A multiplied by C, A and C are the factors. So out of these two we find that A is a common factor. It appears in this term as well as this term and is separated by a addition sign. In that case I have taken the A as common. This is a common term which I have taken out, and this multiplication sign, I have got it here. The multiplication sign which was here, I got it here. And then from my first term, A into B, I've got A. What is remaining? B. I've got it here, B. And from my second term, A into C, I have A here. The remaining is C. I got it here. And when I'm going from the first term to the second term, I encounter in between plus, and that plus comes here. So if you see, this goes here. If you see these two, these two multiplication sign comes here. And we know from this term B is here. And from this term C is here, and A from both of them is common out. So this is the second way we represent distributive property. So this was our first way of representation of distributive property, and this is the second way of representing distributive property. When you do sums related to distributive property, you will need to use both of them. Few times you will need to use this, few times you will need to do this, and both of them are called distributive property representations. You must watch our other videos on whole numbers so that you have complete knowledge of whole numbers. Do not forget to subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon so that you can get notifications whenever we upload new videos. Till we meet again. Bye-bye.